Hey, I'm Ruben, and it's my goal to make lives of .NET developers easier with educational content. So in this tutorial, I'm gonna show you how to build a basic Blazor CRUD application in, I hope, less than 20 minutes and have it running in Azure. I'm on Windows 11 and I'll be using Visual Studio 2022 Preview and .NET 6 Preview 6. So I'm gonna set a stopwatch and get started. To start off, I'm going to open Visual Studio and I'm going to create a new project. I'm going to go for Blazor Server App and I'm going to call it Blazor CRUD 10 Minutes. And for the location, I'm going to do my tutorials in the same directory is fine. Framework .NET 6 Preview, no authentication. HTTPS can stay on, no Docker, and just create it. Okay, and I'm gonna start off by creating the post model. So I'm gonna right click data, add a class, and I'm gonna call it post. And I'm gonna clean up the using statements. And I'm gonna start off by adding the key and importing the required using statement. So that's a property, public int id, and then a required column with a max length of 128, and I'm gonna accept the suggestion. Then another required with a max length of 4096, and that's going to be content. Okay, next up, I'm gonna generate a database from this model. So first off, I'm gonna install some required NuGet packages. So just right click the project, manage NuGet packages, and I'm gonna browse and include pre-release, because I'm on the pre-release. I'm going to search for Microsoft.EntityFrameworkCore. I'm going to download Preview 6. Okay. And I'm also going to install EntityFrameworkCore.design. Again, Preview 6. And Microsoft Entity Framework Core.SQLite. Again, Preview 6. So next up, I'm going to create the DB context. So I'm going to right click data, add a class. I'm going to call that app DB context, and I'm gonna clean up the using statements here. I'm gonna inherit from DB context, import the required using statement. I'm gonna add a DB set property that has a type of post. I'm gonna call it posts, and I'm gonna add a constructor here. And that's gonna stay empty. And that constructor will take a DB context options of type app DB context. I'm gonna call that options. And I'm also gonna run that in the DB context base class. Okay, and then I'm gonna override on model creating, and that has a parameter of type model builder. I'm gonna accept the suggestion here, and I also want to run this in the base class. I'm gonna pass in that model builder object, and now I want to seed some data, so I'm gonna declare a post array and call that post to seed, and that is a new post array of size 10. So I'm gonna seed 10 posts, and then I'm gonna do a for loop. Okay. So int I equals 1, and as long as I is smaller than 11, increment I by 1. And in post to seed, on the index of I minus 1, I want a new post with the following data. So ID equals I, title equals string interpolation post I, and for the content I'm going to do string interpolation. This is some example content for post I. The content is very interesting, and I just wanted it to be 2 sentences long. Okay. I'm gonna add the semicolon. Yeah, and let's actually tell entity framework to seed this data with the asData method. I'm gonna pass in this post to seed array. Awesome. So let's now tell ASP.NET we have a DB context. So I'm gonna open startup.cs, and above add razor pages, I'm gonna add services dot add db context of type app db context, and that has an options object which goes to options dot use SQLite. I'm gonna alt enter, import the required using statement, and the connection string is gonna be data source equals dot slash data slash appdb.db. Okay, so let's generate the database now. So I'm gonna go to the terminal, and I'm gonna type the following command: .NET EF migrations add initial migration, and for the output I'm gonna do data slash migrations. So enter. For some reason it's not working, so I'm gonna restart Visual Studio. Okay, I'm gonna try that same command again. Okay, so now it works. We have this migration folder with our migration in there. And to generate the database, I'm gonna do .NET EF database update. So that applies the migration here. Okay, and there is our database. Okay, so let's do the front end now. So I'm gonna go to pages, index.razor. I'm gonna delete this boilerplate. And I'm gonna start off with some using statements. So using blazor crud 10 mins dot data. I'm gonna go for using Microsoft dot entity framework core, and then I'm gonna add the h1 posts, and here a button with an HTML link. So in that href will go to slash create, and it's gonna get a class of btn success with the content of create. And now I'm gonna display these posts in a table with a class of table responsive table striped. I'm gonna add a table head to that with a table row, and the table heading, I think this is with a scope of call, and with content of ID parentheses primary key. Okay, so just duplicate this line. And here I'm gonna change the content to title. And for this one, I'm gonna change the content to content. And for this one, I'm gonna change content to CRUD. Okay, and now the table body. And I'm gonna add some C# logic here. So if just gonna add a space. If underscore post isn't null, and then display some things. So let's now do the code first. Actually, so I'm gonna inject the app db context. I'm gonna call it app db context. I'm gonna add a get and a set method, and I'm gonna declare a private list of type post. I'm gonna call that underscore post, and that's gonna be a new list of type post. I'm gonna use one of the Blazor lifecycle methods, so protected override async task on initialized async, and in this method I'm gonna do post equals await appdbContext.posts.toListAsync, so we get the post from the database. And I'm gonna add a delete post method, and that takes in a parameter of type post, and I'm gonna name that post to delete. Just scroll down and zoom in a bit, and then appdbContext.posts.remove the post to delete. I'm gonna await appdbContext dot save changes async. Okay, and then from our post list I'm gonna remove that same post to delete. And lastly, we'll say state has changed to re-render the Blazor component. So let's finish this table now. So if posts isn't null, I'm gonna do a for each loop. And for each var post in posts, I'm gonna add a table row and a table heading with a scope of row. I'm gonna give that the addPost.id, and then I'm gonna add a TD field, stands for table data, I believe, not sure. Post.title, control D to duplicate, post.content, control D to duplicate, and in this one the CRUD buttons, so a href equals goes to /update/addPost.id, and I'm gonna give that a class of btn warning. And with the content of update. And here I'm gonna add a button with an onclick of, and then a anonymous function, I believe. Not entirely sure how this is called. Post. So delete post and pass in the post of this for each loop. And I'm gonna give it a class of btn danger. Okay, and let's add some text to this. I'm gonna add the text delete. Okay, and this should work. So I'm gonna create the create page, So I'm going to right click pages, add, erase all component. I'm going to name it create. And I'm going to change it to the following. So add page slash create. And a using statement. So Blazor CRUD 10 mins dot data. And it won't be 10 minutes. I hope it will be 20. Not sure. So I'm going to create post. Add post to create dot title, which doesn't exist yet. So I'll just do the code first. So the code here. Let's start by injecting some things. So our appdb context, and I'll name that appdb context with a get and a set. And I'm gonna inject the navigation manager. I'm gonna name that navigation manager, and that too has a get and a set. I'm gonna declare a private post. I'm gonna name that underscore post to create, which is a new post, and I'm gonna give it some data, initialization data, I believe this is called. So for the title, I'm gonna do post title, and for the content, I'm gonna do post content. Okay. Oh, and this should be underscore post to create. Okay. And now for the create post method, so a private async task create post. I'm gonna await appdb context dot post dot add async and pass in that post to create. And then I'm gonna await appdb context dot save changes async to persist it to the database. And then let's navigate back to the home. So navigation manager dot navigate to slash. Okay, so let's finish this HTML here. So, oh, it's more Razor than HTML. So edit form, and for the model, I'm gonna say the model is post to create, and on valid submit, create the post. Okay, so let's add the fields now. So a div with a class of form group margin bottom 3 and a label for post title, label it title, and a Blazor input text which is self closing, and that's gonna bind to the value post to create dot title, and that's that has a class. Come on, a class of form control and an ID of post title. Okay, so I'm gonna duplicate this for the content. So I'm gonna make use of Visual Studio's find and replace features here. So everywhere where there's title, I want to change that to content, and I have the match case on. I'm gonna press Alt A to do this. So that's good. And then I want to add some data annotations, a data annotations validator, and a validation summary. And then lastly, a button with a class of BTN success, and which is of type submit. Okay, I'm just gonna give it a text of save and another button. I'm gonna remove this type equals submit, and this is a BTN secondary, and for the on click I'm gonna do add parentheses, so we specify that everything in those parentheses is C# code, and then an anonymous method, I believe, or lambda. I always get those mixed up. So navigation manager dot navigate to home. So this is slash. Okay, no mistakes there. And that's gonna have a text of cancel. Okay, let's see how we're doing. I'm probably over 20 minutes here. Unfortunate. Okay, let's see if I can hit 25 minutes. Okay, so now the update component. So I'm gonna copy and paste this create component page. A component which is a page 2. I'm gonna rename this to update. I'm gonna make use of Visual Studio's find and replace features again. So I'm gonna Control F. I'm gonna set it to current document. And I'm gonna change lowercase create to lowercase update alt A. That's only here, I guess. And then uppercase create to uppercase update. Okay, and that saves us some time there. And I'm gonna do slash with a parameter of ID, parameter called ID, which is of type int. Okay. And the rest of this HTML can stay the same. Now in the code, I'm just gonna add this parameter. So parameter, public int, lowercase ID, with a get and a set. And then this private post to update, I'm just gonna initialize to null, which is the default for reference types, I believe, in C#. But I like to be explicit. And let's make use of another lifecycle method. So protected override async task on parameters set async. I'm gonna say post to update equals await appdb context dot post dot find async. I'm gonna pass in that ID parameter, and here in update post I'm gonna do appdb context dot post dot update the post to update, and then persist that to the database. And this is not asynchronous, so I'm gonna remove the await. Await appdb context dot save changes async. Yeah, the rest can stay the same. All right, and we're done. Let's run the application locally. So just .NET watch. Okay, it seems to be working. Let's create, update, and add a post. So create. Okay, it's created. Update. Post title updated. Save. Seems to be updated. Let's delete it. Okay, and it's deleted. So it works. Let's publish it to Azure now. I'm just gonna stop it from running. And I'm gonna tuck everything in except for this appdb. I'm going to specify I want this to copy to output directory, copy always, which is Azure. We want to upload this database to Azure. If you have published to Azure once, I recommend you set this back to do not copy, or your database in Azure will get overridden by your local one every time you publish. I'm going to right click this project here and hit publish. And then I'm going to select Azure, hit next, app service windows, next. I'm going to create a new app service and I'm going to name it Blazor CRUD 10 Mins, which is inaccurate at this point. And the resource group is going to be tutorials. And I'm going to create a new hosting plan and I'm going to call that ASP for app service plan. And then the name of the app service. Location Western Europe for me. Size is 3 for tutorial videos. And I'm just gonna hit create. Alright, so I initially thought this would take 10 minutes, but that was a little too optimistic. It's more like 30 minutes, which is still pretty fast, I'd say, for a CRUD application actually hosted in the cloud. So, okay, looks good. So I'm gonna hit finish. All right, and I'm just gonna change the deployment mode to self-contained. So this reduces bugs for me. All right, and then I'm gonna hit publish. Okay, awesome, and it seems to be working. So I'm just gonna try the CRUD operations here. So I'm gonna create a new post and I'm gonna update this. All right, and that works. And I'm gonna delete it. Okay, so there you go. A basic Blazor server CRUD application in, let's check the stopwatch, 30 minutes, not bad. Thanks for watching, I appreciate it. I'll leave a link in the description to download the source code created in this video. If you have a question or have a suggestion for me to make a video on, let me know in the comments below and I'll try to help you out. Like and subscribe, it's free and it motivates me to make more free videos. That's all from me, good luck in your developer journey.